So we start with this next numerical, and the question is, calculate the number of moles and molecules in 22 grams of it. Okay, now students, first of all we have to read the question thrice. Okay, and the question says that we have to calculate moles, we have to calculate molecules. Okay, but where we have to calculate, how many moles are present in 22 grams? Okay, how many moles and how many molecules, but in acetic acid. So what we will do is, we will begin this numerical as follows. First we will find out that 1 mole of acetic acid corresponds to what. Okay, 1 mole of acetic acid. So for carbon I wrote 12, for hydrogen I wrote 3 into 1, for carbon I wrote 12, for oxygen 16 16 and 1. All right, so when you calculate this, you'll be getting 60 gram per mole. Fine, so 60 gram per mole is the molecular mass of acetic acid. Now, as I said, the question is, calculate the number of moles in 22 grams of acetic acid. Okay, now students, one mole is corresponding to 60 grams. How many moles will correspond to 22 grams? So we are going to flip this, and in this way we are going to calculate. 60 gram is equivalent to 1 mole. So 22 gram would be equivalent to how much? It will be 22 into 1 upon 60, as I have already solved over here for you. 60, okay, 22 into 1 upon 60 is equal to these many moles. Now, the second part of the question is, calculate the number of molecules of acetic acid in 22 grams. Now, 1 mole of acetic acid contains these many molecules. All right, then 0.366 moles. Why 0.366 moles? Because these many moles are present in 22 grams. So we will multiply number of moles by number of molecules. Okay, so we will be getting answer as 2.2076 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. Okay, are present in acetic acid. Fine. Now, here we have next numerical, and the question is, yes, we will begin like this. 24 gram of carbon reacts with some oxygen. So we need to have one rough plan of this, and it is 24 grams of carbon reacts with some oxygen. So we are having carbon and it is reacting with some oxygen, and we are getting CO2. Okay, just see, I have written over here, carbon and oxygen, they are reacting and we are getting CO2. Fine, 24 grams. Now they are saying that it is 24 gram reacting, and it is giving this information, and this information is given. 24 is reacting to give 88 grams. Okay, how much oxygen that will have, how much oxygen must be used? Now they are asking this question mark already I have put. Now how are we going to solve this? We will solve it like this, that 12 gram of carbon is using 32 gram of oxygen according to the given equation. Okay, so 24 gram of carbon will be using how much oxygen? Okay, just see, I have written that 12 is using 32, 24 will use how much? So simple multiplication and then divide by 12, so you will be getting 64 grams of oxygen. I hope this numerical was very easy for you to understand. Yes, here we have next numerical. Calculate the number of atoms present in each of the following. Okay, means we have to calculate how many atoms are present. Okay, we have to calculate number of atoms where, students, in 0.4 mole of nitrogen. Okay, now we know that 1 mole of nitrogen, okay, 1 mole of nitrogen contains how many atoms? Avogadro number. Okay, then 0.4 will contain how many? Here we have to just multiply 0.4 into N0. Fine, so just see, I have done this. 1 mole of nitrogen contains Avogadro number of atoms, then 0.4 will contain how much? So multiply, cross multiply, you will be getting this answer. Fine. Next question is, find out the number of atoms in 1.6 gram of sulfur. Okay, now atomic mass of sulfur is given 32. 32 atomic mass, 32 mu means 32 gram per mole. Okay, So if 1 mole of sulfur is having the mass 32 grams, okay, then and which is containing 6.022 × 10²³ sulfur atoms, okay, then 1.6 gram will be having how many sulfur atoms? Okay, I hope you understood this. They are saying that 32 grams is containing Avogadro number. So 1.6 gram will be having how many atoms into it? Okay, 1.6 gram will be having how many atoms into it? So 1.6 × N₀/32. Okay, yes, that is only written 1.6 × Avogadro number upon 32. So when you solve this, you will be getting answer as 3.0111 × 10²² atoms of sulfur. All right. Now we move on to next question, and the question is 2.0 gram of metal is burnt in oxygen to give 3.2 gram of its oxide. So we will write this information on this paper and we will try to solve it. 2.0 gram of metal. So metal is there, oxygen is there, and we are getting metal oxide. It is just a rough, okay, rough calculation. So I am not even balancing now. M is there and the mass is 2.0 gram, and we are getting 3.2 gram. All right. Now they are saying that 1.42 gram of the same metal is heated in steam, and it is giving 2.27 gram of its oxide. It means, students, they are saying that we are getting over here metal oxide using another method. And what is that method? That metal is heated with the steam. All right, metal is heated with the steam, and this time the metal was 1.42 gram and the metal oxide is 2.27 grams. Okay, now the question is, which law is verified by this data? Okay, so how to calculate this or how to solve this? What we will do is, we will find out in this question, we will find out the percentage of metal. Okay, I'll use another marker. Percentage of metal in metal oxide. Okay, percentage of oxygen in metal oxide, first case. Okay, same percentage of metal and percentage of oxide in the second case, and if both happens to be same, then it is definitely law of definite proportion. Let us see how I have solved this question. Okay, so I have written over here that metal plus oxygen forming metal oxide, metal and steam forming metal oxide, first method, second method. Now metal oxide is obtained by two methods, as I have already discussed with you. Okay, now the mass of oxygen in the metal oxide is 3.2 − 1.2 gram. Okay, now as I have already mentioned over here, that reaction, fine. So we are getting here, see, here it is 2, fine, and here it is 3.2, fine. So what is the mass of oxygen? Okay, so 3.2 − 2, just 3.2 − 1.2. Let me check this. This 3.2 − 2.0. All right, it was not written earlier. 3.2 − 2.0. I'll write here 2.0. Okay, so 3.2 − 2.0 is what? 1.2 gram. All right. Now, what I'll do now? Percentage of oxygen. Okay, percentage of oxygen is 1.2 / 3.2 × 100, 37.5%. फिर हम क्या करेंगे? फिर हम percentage of metal भी देखेंगे. Percentage of metal कैसे मिलेगा? Mass of the metal upon mass of the metal oxide. Okay, into 100. तो ये हमें मिल गया percentage of oxygen. ये हमें मिल गया percentage of metal in the metal oxide, जो हमें मिला है पहले तरीके से, that is reaction with the oxygen. Okay, now next is reaction with steam. Okay, so mass of oxygen in the metal oxide, हम क्या करेंगे? Metal oxide का mass लिया है minus mass of metal लिया है, and this is the mass of oxygen. All right, so percentage of oxygen is equal to mass of oxygen upon mass of metal oxide into 100. So we got this. Please note what is the answer. 37.5%. प्लीज़ नोट व्हाट इज़ द आंसर योर 37.5%, मतलब परसेंटेज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज सेम, इजंट इट? लेट अस सी द मेटल. सो परसेंटेज ऑफ मेटल क्या होगा? मेटल का मास अपॉन मेटल ऑक्साइड का मास इंटू 100, एंड वी विल बी गेटिंग 62.5%. सी योर 62.5%. तो स्टूडेंट्स, अ गिवन कंपाउंड कंटेन्स सेम एलिमेंट्स इन द सेम प्रोपोर्शन. इसीलिए फ्रॉम द अबव डेटा लॉ ऑफ डेफिनाइट प्रोपोर्शन इज वेरीफाइड. लॉ ऑफ डेफिनाइट प्रोपोर्शन क्या होता है? लॉ ऑफ डेफिनाइट प्रोपोर्शन कहता है कि अगर आप कोई कंपाउंड लेट अस से अगर आप किसी भी कंपाउंड को, पानी है ठीक है, यू आर रिट्राइविंग और यू आर ब्रिंगिंग वाटर फ्रॉम लेक, ओके, फ्रॉम रिवर, फ्रॉम वेल, ठीक है, फ्रॉम योर टैप और फ्रॉम दी फ्रॉम योर लेबॉरेटरी, ओके. तो पानी जो है, ओके, द सोर्सेज ऑफ वाटर आर मैनी. आई हैव जस्ट रिटन फ्यू सोर्सेज. लॉ ऑफ डेफिनेट प्रोपोर्शन सेज दैट अ पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ इट्स सोर्सेज, ओके, दैट पर्टिकुलर कंपाउंड विल ऑलवेज कंटेन सेम एलिमेंट्स कंबाइंड इन द फिक्स्ड प्रोपोर्शन बाय मास. मतलब पानी को आप किसी भी सोर्स से कलेक्ट कर लो, पानी के अंदर हमेशा और हमेशा हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन जो है वो 2:1 के रेशियो में रहेंगे, ओके, वो 2:1 के रेशियो में रहेंगे, ओके. सिमिलरली अगर हम CO2 की बात करते हैं, CO2 आप अलग अलग सोर्सेस से CO2 को कलेक्ट करो, ओके, इट विल ऑलवेज कंटेन कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन इन द रेशियो ऑफ 1:2. यही है लॉ ऑफ डेफिनाइट प्रोपोर्शन. यस, हियर वी हैव अनदर न्यूमेरिकल एंड इट इज इन 2 moles ऑफ एसिटाल्डिहाइड, दैट इज CH3CHO, कैलक्यूलेट. व्हाट वी हैव टू कैलक्यूलेट ओवर हियर? वी हैव टू कैलक्यूलेट नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ कार्बन, ओके. तो द क्वेश्चन इज that we are having CH3CHO, okay, and they are asking how many moles of carbon is present. Now see students, in 1 mole how many carbons can you see? How many carbons can you see? 1 and 2, okay. So 1 mole is containing 2 carbon atoms, isn't it? 1 mole is containing 2 carbon atoms. So they are calculating in 2 moles. So 2 moles will contain how many carbon atoms? Yes, it is going to be 4. You are correct. Okay. So just see what I have written here. 1 mole of acetaldehyde contains 2 moles of carbon. So 2 moles will contain how many? So this was a very easy numerical, isn't it? Now followed by this, we are having number of moles of hydrogen. We have to calculate number of moles of hydrogen in 2 moles of CH3CHO. Okay. So, now see, 1 mole of acetaldehyde contains 3 plus 1, 4. 4 moles of hydrogen. So, if 1 mole is containing 4 moles of hydrogen, then 2 moles of acetaldehyde will contain how many moles of hydrogen? Yes, we have to multiply, okay, 8 moles of hydrogen. Next is, calculate the number of moles of oxygen in 2 moles, okay, 2 moles of what? Acetaldehyde. Fine. Now, 1 mole of acetaldehyde contains 1 mole of oxygen, isn't it? So 2 moles will contain how many? 2 into 1, 2 moles of oxygen. Yes, here we have the last optional question for it. Number of molecules of CH3CHO. So 1 mole of acetaldehyde contains Avogadro number of molecules. So 2 moles will contain how many? 2 moles will contain 2 into 6.02, 2 into 10 raised to 23 molecules present in it. Now, here we have this numerical, calculate the number of moles of MgO in 80 grams, okay. So we have to find out that in 80 grams how many moles are present, okay. We have to find out 80 grams, okay, how many moles are present, नाउ 80 ग्राम्स ऑफ वॉट स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज MgO. ठीक है, नाउ दिस मच वी शुड नो दैट व्हाट इज द मोलर मास ऑफ MgO. इट इज 24 प्लस 16, दैट इज 40. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स 40 ग्राम कंटेन्स 1 मोल. ओके, सो 80 विल कंटेन हाउ मेनी? 80 इंटू 1 अपॉन 40. लेट अस सी व्हाट आई हैव रिटन हियर. चेक, 40 ग्राम्स ऑफ MgO इज 1 मोल ऑफ MgO. सो 80 ग्राम्स विल बी हाउ मेनी मोल्स? Okay, it would be 80 into 1 upon 40, that is 20 moles. Now, we have to find out in 10 grams also. So, 40 grams of MgO is having 1 mole of MgO. So, 10 grams will be having how many? 10 into 1 upon 40, that is 0.25. I hope you have understood this concept very nicely. Okay, please practice these numericals after you watch this video, or during when you are watching this video, that time also you can pause the video and you can solve along with me. Okay, next question is, what is the volume of CO2 occupied by 5 moles? Okay, now students, see, we know that 1 mole is occupying 22.4 decimeter cube volume. Okay, so 5 moles will occupy how much? Yes, you guessed it correctly, 5 into 22.4. Okay, so answer is 112 decimeter cube volume. Yes, what is the volume of CO2 occupied by 0.5 also, students? So how we will calculate this 0.5? We'll calculate like this. 1 mole is occupying this much volume, 0.5 will occupy how much? 22.4 into 0.5, and then we got the answer. Now children, next question is, calculate the mass of potassium chlorate. Calculate the mass of potassium chlorate required to liberate 6.72 gram of oxygen. Students, before we solve this question, okay, we should know what is the formula of potassium chlorate. Now, since it is given over here, I'll write here KClO3. Now, they are saying that we have to find out the mass of potassium chlorate. Okay, fine. Now, which is required to liberate, मतलब इस रिएक्शन में ऑक्सीजन इज गेटिंग लिबरेटेड. ओके, तो कहीं ना कहीं इन्होंने हमें एक हिंट दे दी है रिएक्शन की. ठीक है, रिएक्शन ये है, और ये पूछ रहे हैं कि कितने ग्राम्स ऑफ KClO3 ने, ओके, 6.72 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑक्सीजन बनाया. ठीक है, ये सॉल्व करने से पहले हमें सबसे पहले रिएक्शन लिखना है, पॉइंट नंबर वन. सेकेंड, रिएक्शन को बैलेंस करना है. ओके, सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आई हैव डन ओवर हियर. ओके, आई जस्ट पुट दिस पेपर. यस, KClO3 मैंने रिएक्शन लिखा पहले, फिर मैंने उसे बैलेंस किया. ओके, 2K 2K 2Cl 2Cl 6 6. ऑल राइट, नाउ रिएक्शन के हिसाब से अगर देखें तो 2 मोल्स ऑफ पोटेशियम क्लोरेट ने 3 मोल्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन दिया. यस, नाउ 2 मोल्स ऑफ पोटेशियम क्लोरेट मतलब क्या है? 2 × 1 = 2.5 ग्राम्स. ओके, बिकॉज मोलर मास दिया हुआ है. ठीक है, 3 मोल्स ऑफ ऑक्सीजन मतलब क्या है? 3 × 22.4 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, मैंने यहाँ ग्राम लिखा है और मैंने यहाँ वॉल्यूम लिखा है, क्योंकि हमें क्वेश्चन में जो डेटा दिया है वो भी वॉल्यूम में दिया है. ओके, सो रिएक्शन के हिसाब से हमें पता चलता है कि 2 × 1 = 2.5 ग्राम पोटेशियम क्लोरेट जो है वो रिएक्ट करता है और देता है 3 × 22.4 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. लेकिन x ग्राम अगर होगा तो वो दे रहा है 6.72 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. इसी चीज़ को स्टूडेंट्स, मैंने इसको फ्लिप कर दिया, मैंने इसको फ्लिप कर दिया. मतलब मैंने क्या किया है, जस्ट सी, यहाँ पे देखो, दिस टू टिक मार्क्स, यू सी, 3 × 22.4 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज लिबरेटेड बाय दिस मेनी ग्राम्स ऑफ KClO3. तो 6.72 डेसीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ ऑक्सीजन जो है, इट विल बी लिबरेटेड बाय हाउ मेनी ग्राम्स ऑफ KClO3? ओके, मैंने इसको क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई किया है एंड देन डिवाइड किया है, एंड देन आई गॉट 24.0 ग्राम्स ऑफ KClO3. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल्स विच आई हैव डिस्कस्ड. प्लीज़ कॉमेंट हाउ डिड यू लाइक द वीडियो. थैंक यू सो मच. सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल and hit the bell icon. Thank you.